Again, when you have a fraction, you're going to have to simplify the numerator and the denominator separately. Now, if you want, since this is being subtracted from 6 squared, you can do the 6 squared on the first step because that's separated by the minus sign. Remember, the last thing you're going to do is subtract. So this is 36 minus, but let's simplify the numerator and denominator here. No canceling. Cancel that 5 into 45 or that 5 into that 5. No way. So we've got 45 divided by 5, that's 9. And 5 minus 2 in the denominator is 3. And I don't do 36 minus 9. Now I have to simplify 9 divided by 3. So I have 36 minus 9 divided by 3 is 3. It's a whole number. So my answer is 33. And there we go. All right, let's do this one. Again, basically you have something minus something else plus something else. So we can go ahead and do this 5 times 2 first and the 3 squared at the same time that we're simplifying this numerator and denominator here. So let's go ahead and do that. So 5 times 2, because that's going to come before that subtraction anyway. And this 3 squared we could do. All right, now let's simplify these. In the numerator, 16 minus 4, that's 12. Now in the denominator, I need to use the order of operations. So I've got exponents, so I've got 2 squared, that's 4 plus 2. All right, so we're not done simplifying the denominator yet, so I have to copy up to there. So I've got 12 over 6. All I could do is just keep on with this plus 9. And now I can simplify the 12 divided by 6. Remember, 12 over 6 means 12 divided by 6. So this would be minus 2 plus 9. And now I go left to right. Do not add the 2 plus the 9. So I have 10 minus 2 is 8 plus 9. Final answer, 17. So there are some problems using the order of operations that where you're also dealing with fractions, but we haven't dealt with any negative numbers yet. So have fun. Okay, we're going to work on a problem that's a little bit more complicated using the order of operations with fractions. All right, our first step would be to see if there is anything to simplify within grouping symbols such as parentheses or brackets. And no, there is not. There are parentheses, but it's just around the number 2/3, so there's nothing to simplify there. Second, you simplify anything that has exponents. And here's where I take the 2/3 squared, and I'm going to just write that. You can either write that as 2/3 times 2/3, or you could simplify that and just write 4/9, which I'm going to do. 2/3 times 2/3 is simply going to be 4/9. So you could rewrite it as the multiplication or simplify it. All right, now what's going on over here? We have a division with fractions. Remember, that means to multiply by the reciprocal. So that would be 5/6 times 9/10. Dividing by 10/9 is the same as multiplying by 9/10. Okay, so we've done anything with exponents, and I've just switched the division to be multiplying by the reciprocal. So next would be any multiplication or division, because we're not going to do any subtraction until the end, right? So these 4s cancel, that's nice. So that the number on the left of the minus sign will just be 11/9. All right, and what's happening over on the right-hand side? Let's see, between the 5 and the 10, that cancels because 5 goes into each of those numbers. So 5 goes into 5 once and 5 goes into 10 twice. All right, now I also have the 6 and 9. So 3 goes into each of those numbers. So if I divide 6 by 3, I have 2, and 9 by 3, I have 3. So I'm going to get 3/4. So I have 11 ninths minus 3 fourths. Now we have to do 11 ninths minus 3 fourths. There's different ways of doing this, but you do need a common denominator if you're going to use that method. So 9 and 4 have nothing in common, so the least common denominator is going to be 36. So if I multiply the left side by 4 over 4, I'll have 36ths, and the right side by 9 over 9, I'll have 36ths. So this would give me 44 over 36 minus 27 over 36. And now I just have to do 44 minus 27, which is, I think, 17. 36. All right, so you can use the order of operations, but you've got to be careful with fractions. Remember, I did a lot of different things in this one problem. I squared a fraction. I remembered the division was multiplying by the reciprocal. I remembered I had to cancel when I multiplied. I had to get a common denominator in order to subtract. It's like, wow, there was a lot going on in this one problem. So if you could do this one, then I think you've got order of operations down fairly well and fractions. Try this all on your own and then see if you come back and get the same answer, 1736. And then just have fun with order of operations. I hope you learned something. Remember, math is